Being a slow typist comes with a few problems. I've had problems taking notes during classes, meetings at work, and with clients while freelancing. I just was way too slow. So I decided to learn touch typing, which is basically typing with all of your fingers, including the pinkies, without looking at the keyboard and really fast. Typing speed is usually measured in words per minute, and that's what I'm going to use in this video. According to David Allen, the author of Getting Things Done, if you can't touch type at least 60 words per minute with a low error rate, you're seriously crippling your ability to do productive work. My typing speed was way below that. My typing speed was at only 25 words per minute, which is below average, and I only used my indexes and thumbs to do it. So I needed to do something about it. I learned touch typing in 4 steps, the first one being overcoming unconscious incompetence. Apart from angrily typing in video games and trying to make jokes in a group chat before the subject changes, I've never really been able to type efficiently and precisely. I never had courses in school teaching me touch typing, so I had to create my own little program to go from step 1 to step 4. To go from step 1 to step 2, conscious incompetence, I had to know what I needed to learn and to become better at. And I needed to relearn to type using all of my fingers, not look at the keyboard while doing so, and do it faster. Now that I knew what I needed to work on, I could focus on the first thing, which was relearning how to type. For this, I used the website Typing Jungle, which has hundreds of free lessons to help you master touch typing. The first few hours where I had to train my fingers independently were really uncomfortable, so much that my typing speed went back to around 15 words per minute. But as I went through the lessons, I got more comfortable and got to a solid 40 words per minute. Doing all the levels on Typing Jungle took me around 1 week, and I trained for around 1 hour a day on average. I used the AZERTY keyboard layout because I'm French. At the end of the lessons, I was using my fingers correctly, but I really had to focus to do so. But still, I was able to switch to the next step, conscious competence, where I changed my strategy. The goal wasn't to get the grasp of how touch typing worked, but it was to be better and faster at it, without looking at the keyboard. With a typing speed of around 40 words per minute, I thought it was pretty reasonable to try to double it in 1 month. To really become proficient, I had to practice touch typing until it became engraved in my mind. So I decided to give myself the goal of typing at 80 words per minute with a precision rate higher than 95%. During these 30 days, I prepared a quick daily training program for myself, which lasts around 15 minutes a day. I am baguette, which also means that I also communicate in French throughout my day, so I practiced both English and French. My program was 3 tries on 10 fast fingers in French, 3 tries in English, 3 tries on Typeracer, and every day I tracked my best result for each exercise in a spreadsheet, and I would try to beat my high score each time. I think it was really important to see it as a game every day, because if I saw it as a chore, it would have been really hard to remain consistent. It was a bit tedious, but I managed to train every single day at typing faster for around 15 minutes, and during my last week of training, I finally achieved it. During these 30 days, I was able to improve by making use of deliberate practice, which James Clear, author of Atomic Habits, defines as a special type of practice that is purposeful and systematic. While regular practice might include mindless repetitions, deliberate practice requires focused attention and is conducted with the specific goal of improving performance. And I think that focusing on only a few key elements and trying to improve them consistently helps to achieve meaningful progress, even with a small time investment. It was a good decision to spread out the learning over 30 days and not making it super dense, as learning touch typing relies on muscle memory, which usually cannot be trained efficiently with long sessions. For a total time investment of around 15 hours over the course of 5 weeks, I think that it was totally worth it to learn touch typing, and now I feel way more comfortable using my keyboard for various tasks, and the less effort I need to put into typing, the more time and energy I have to do higher value tasks. So I think that I'm going to try to apply deliberate practice to more aspects in my life, like coding or music, or even knowledge work, and try to improve by 1% each day. The resources I mentioned in this video, like the websites or the little training program I prepared, are available in the description. And if you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to see more in the future, and I will see you in the next one.